Stanford University.
We have with us the rock stars of the environmental and energy sector in the United States, and I am just so thrilled to be able to introduce them to you.
The most challenging aspect of the climate problem is the urgency of action and the consequence of delaying, even by a few years or a few decades. We know that we're going to continue to use fossil fuels for some time in the future. And the only way that we can transition effectively off is to start now. The longer you wait, the more it costs, the more complicated solutions get to be, and the more residual impacts you deal with. There's no reason to wait because there are smart, effective, low-cost things we could be doing today.
We make decisions amid uncertainty all of the time. We make decisions about bets on financial markets that we're going to invest in. We make decisions about what university we're going to attend. We make decisions about what course of treatment to take. Think of when you're a patient in front of a doctor. Frankly, we make decisions to avoid risks. We make decisions as a society to avoid harm, and that's what we need to do in this case.
Yes, I think the business side is critical to solve this problem, and that's an important first step. But there's 90 companies in the world that generate two-thirds of all global emissions. So it's really there that we have to put pressure.
I just find it impossible to sit on the stage at Maple's Pavilion and say we cannot innovate technically, that we can't come up with new solutions to problems that are better, cheaper, cleaner. That just seems to me to be entirely illogical and a real disservice to American research and American business.
I think the problems are daunting, and they come at a time when governments are weakening. I say, yes, it's a tough road out there, but it can be. We've had so many tough roads in the past that we've dealt with that I'm sure we can do this one.
For more, please visit us at stanford.edu.